We just saw you moments ago roll in a couple putts here on our Callaway Corner. And you were saying, I overheard you, that it's been a while since you got out there on the golf course.
Don't get out much. That movie, that Tin Cup movie kind of gave people the impression that was something I did all the time. And then playing at Pebble Beach, that reinforced it. So, but I don't. And I think sometimes when I play, it's in front of millions of people. I know guys that can't tee off at the first tee because some guy eating pancakes at Bel Air goes, and they... But every time I play, it feels like it's in front of a billion people.
Right. Well, what sort of preparation did you do for that movie? I mean,
Gary McCord and Pete Costas tried to help me as much as I could. But as we all know, too much information about golf, it's just I could only absorb a few things.
Right.
The one thing that I took away in that thing is I wouldn't have a beautiful swing there. He was a little West Texas golfer, used to play on Muni courses in the wind. So everything was like a knockdown shot. So I kind of played the movie that way a lot. I mean, he made it up kind of like Trevino, if you would. But those guys were always great. And, I had, great experiences. In fact, I actually played a Palm Spring thing because they wanted to try to introduce me to golf as much as I could.
Sure.
They said, come down and do the Palm Spring thing. And I go, okay. And I swear to God, and I watched, it's not like I'm a rube, but you don't really get it quite away, when you're doing it with them. And on the second hole, I feel like I picked up everybody's marks. I picked up my money. I thought we were out of the hole. And there was a moment in time where actually the marshal there froze. Everybody froze. It was like on the second hole, I picked up Gary's thing or whatever. And I realized something had happened. I remember I quick saw the marshal who saw what happened. He was sitting right on his little three stool thing right
yes.
there. And I said, I picked this up. I'm putting it right back where we're just going to keep going, okay? And I did. He looked at me, and I don't know, my voice carried.
Yes.
And I said, I'm putting it right back down here. Let's not make a big deal about this. I was just picking up the stuff. It was like.
And so He played on.
I had another terrible experience. I might as well just
go
tell
for
this.
It. No, go for it, Kevin.
That same experience was also with pros. It was that pro-am out there. And I don't know why I'm telling you this, but I'm out there, and I'm now going to be between Peter Jacobson and somebody else, and I'm like anything. I don't want to necessarily go hit in front of them right away, Seventh grade, you don't want to take your first shower in front of everybody. It's like, what am I going to do here? I don't want to hit. I'm not sure how to go about this. And so I'm kind of waiting for my spot, and my caddy, who's a kid I was sponsoring at USC, he comes over, and he goes, what's in your bag? And I said, what? He goes, your bag. And I said, what are you talking about? Because I'm waiting. He goes, I had two guns in there. What was it? I hadn't been in my bag for about 7 months after that movie. When I was out there in Arizona, because I wasn't that great at golf, I loved like hunting quail and rabbits. So I'd play about six holes in the evening when the light was perfect.
Right.
And then I had a little 22 and two little 22s, a pistol and a thing. And so I would get some quail or some rabbit, and that's what I did. That was still in the bag because it had the head covers on it. So he goes, what do I do? And I said, he goes, there's ammo too. And I go, well, there should be, but he goes, I go, what do you got? I said, just take it back to the car. I don't want to hit in front of these guys anyway. I could use the stall. He was white faced because he was going to be a pro.
Well, the ammo is usually a Callaway.
It's heavy. Yeah.
And the iron, there's no 22 iron in the bag usually.
The head cover was over the thing. I'd take my young son out and we would start playing at four when the sun got low and we would hunt. There was nobody on the course.
And so your caddy just remain calm.
Well, that was
good.
You got to go take it because it's heavy. It was heavy.
That's right, because normally when a bag is heavy, they're looking in there to see what they could take out if they're going to be.
Yeah, he knew right away
bag.
Something was wrong, so he couldn't figure out. He counted the clubs, but he didn't take that head cover off. He says it's still ready, and he pulled it off, and then there's the 22.
For more of The Rich Eisen Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV for free on BR Live or download The Rich Eisen Show app.